Hey guys, today we are going to look at the Manosaurus Weds and how he deals with, quote, trolls, end quote. So, Weds is not a big fan of mine or Jeremy on Sleeve Medias. And here he calls out Jeremy as a liar and a coward. You pathetic mess of a person. So that's interesting. Lying and being a coward. Now, the Wet Manosaurus has said many times that he, for many years, did not fight back against Jeremy. So who was a coward then? But of course, he grew stronger and stronger. With every donation, he grew a tiny bit stronger until he became $75,000 stronger. So, and yet you still go out of your way to search for my Twitter page and stalk my tweet replies to find things to trash me on. Let's ask the viewers, why do you think HQ is so obsessed with me? Now, here is the back and forth, and it benefits both parties. If you know anything about PR, and yes, I do a tiny bit of PR, but we do outsource it to my friend in New York, Lana. Very good person. What happens is, from a news coverage, you report the outrage, or you report, I'll take something called, let's say a really famous person did something, and we don't know if it's true or not true. Well, we're going to report that it's true. And the reason we do that is, we get lots of likes, lots of views, lots of newspapers sold, and then once if we find out that's not true, which we should have known, but no one did research, this happens all the time in PR, we then report our outrage that it's not true. So you see, we double dipped. Let me go over this again. Let's say that something we don't know, like if Rudy is true or not true, is Tolarian referring to Rudy or himself, who really knows? Well, you report it the first time as true. Tolarian is saying that Rudy shouldn't charge $5, and he never charges $5, although his patron says that, and Wedge the same thing. Now, even if it's true, then you get all those views, all those spicy likes, and all that stuff, and myself included. I'm not your role model. I'm a lion. So, your role model should not be animals, by the way. So what happens here is, regardless of it's true or not true, it will be reported as true. And then if it's later discovered as not true, then there's another outrage. So this whole cycle benefits the Manosaurus and Tolarian Community College above all else, because if you dislike those two, nothing can change your mind to like them. Nothing will happen where you would want to donate to them. But if you like them, that will entrench you even more. Each of these cycles, just like Trump and Hillary, it ingrains the subscribers already. So Wedge has fans who donate large amounts of money. I mean, it's not a joke that he raised $75,000 in a blink of an eye. He has people donating money to him. Same with Tolarian. It's not a mystery that someone donated $10,000 for him to fix his semi-flooded. I live in Houston. Come on, your basement is not flooded, dude. Like, not compared to us. Not compared to Hurricane Harvey. We don't even have basements. Our first level is flooded, right? With mold. But, okay, he gets $10,000. Snap, you know. So what happens is, it is in their best interest to get the people who are already going to donate to them to donate at a higher tier. We need to fight unsleeved media, is what they're saying. And to do that, we need your hard-earned cast to give me a six-figure plus salary. And that's PR. So, Wedge used to have a board of all the YouTubers, big and small, who did magic, and their subscriber number. I wonder if he still has it. He hasn't made any videos recently since his, I think, mental breakdown. I love strong people. I love when someone is, very intelligent. I mean, in terms of my dating preference, I don't really care what you look like. I don't care what you weigh. I don't care your race. Like, that's why, like, whenever these people talk about it, as it's so irrelevant to me. It's not. I care about, can you hold a conversation? Can you talk intelligently? And I typically date people who are smarter than I am, because I like that. It's interesting. Makes a controversies easier to talk about, and you can go over this stuff. I think this is the opposite of what's happening here. Is people like other people who are always victims, because then they feel better when they donate money. So I work at, when I was in middle school, I worked at this place called Sunrise Retirement Home. I used to play piano, and I used to call bingo every Thursday night. If I wasn't there, then they don't get bingo night, and it's kind of what they look forward to every week. The piano is like hit or miss, right? They could care less about that, but they're really passionate about bingo night on Thursday. Same night as Survivor. And what happens here is I have volunteered all my life. My first week at NYU, I volunteered for a beach cleanup with then some of my best friends. I would later find out they would be my best friends. And we picked tires. We did, I think it was Surf Rider or something with NYU that first week. And then that whole semester, I volunteered to teach little kids at the public school, at the H something public school. I have pictures of the school and stuff, and it's all recorded. And I have been volunteering all my life. Even when I was in law school, I volunteered at something called CARE. And CARE helps people who are in a deportation facility, which, if, in case you don't want to know what a deportation facility looks like, it's like a jail. It's a jail. It's a jail where you wait until you're going to be deported. And I would have these forms, and they would send me out to like the rec hall, and I would take, it's like, it was kind of scary the first time, but then like then you look around and security guards everywhere, and like, oh, okay, so nothing's going to happen to me. And that's what I did. I still do all that stuff. I still I volunteer with animals now, but these are not the people who you want to have. These are not the people who are going to give time. These are not the people who need help. I've seen people and animals who really need help, and I've seen the people who are willing to help them. Most situations cannot be resolved from just money. It has to be time, it has to be commitment. There's so many reasons why, let's say a graphic designer or a video editor, like, if they help to Larry make the video, that makes more sense to me than them just giving him money to spend on aged steak. Same with Wedge. Like, if somebody really wanted to help him, they could be a, hey Wedge, you need to get health insurance. Hey Wedge, you need to save for retirement. So you want to help change a person so they're not always falling into victimhood. That's the help you need to give them. By giving, let's take a homeless person, which in many cases isn't all that different here, because a homeless person relies on donations as well as their main source of income. And they do have homes. I know it sounds ironic, but a lot of homeless people have homes in Houston. I was with my intern the other 2 Saturdays ago, and we saw this guy giving out sandwiches. We took a picture of him, and unfortunately, he was like too far. We tried to talk to him, but then we couldn't find him. But he was just giving sandwiches out to all these homeless people on a Sunday. And I thought, yeah, that would be really good. Let me do that. And that's what we did. That is what we did. My birthday is July 1st. Do you know what I did on my birthday? I gave sandwiches to homeless people. Yeah, I thought that was really cool. Now, I didn't go this week because, I can't go every week. But nonetheless, and actually, I talked to the owners of, it's like a deli, Murphy's Deli. And I said, oh, this is what I'm doing. And they gave me a really good discount on about 50 sandwiches. Now, 50 was too much because what happened was, it was, what is it, 100 degrees? It was really hot. And we didn't have any sand. It was really hot. Like, okay, I remember that day. My gosh, it was like really hot. and we had water, and we had bags. It was me, my intern, Jess, and Norman, and we all had like 20, 25 sandwiches. And I think we had a few sandwiches left over, and we wanted to put them back in the fridge, but they were already like rotten. I do have pictures of it, but next time I'll take video of it. I don't know. I had video of me in when I was in San Francisco and I was living the high life, the quote investor back life. I used to take videos, and I think I posted one here, and I posted a few on my other channel when I was in San Francisco. But I would go to a really nice restaurant, and I would always order another entree, and then I would take the entree in a box, and this is very expensive, like $40-$45 an entree, and then I would give it to a homeless person. And I used to take videos of it because I thought that like it was cool. And you know, I might have a video on this channel, but I don't remember if I do. That was a few years ago when I was in San Francisco. There's so many like good things to donate money to. There's so many great charities. There's so many great people in need, in dire need. But hey, you want that signed card, good luck to you.